Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to set up C++ in your Visual Studio Code. So first I'll be showing you how to download and install MinGW, which is a C++ compiler, and also how to install Visual Studio Code, and finally I'll be showing you how to set up both. So let's get started. First just Google MinGW and we'll be having the link from sourceforge.net. Click it. And here we'll be having the MinGW for Windows. So just click on download and the download will be getting started. It's just a setup file, 84 KB in size. So just click it and click on install. So that is going to be the installation directory. If you want to change it, you can change it. Just click on continue. And this will take some time to download. Just be patient. So once all the necessary things have been downloaded, you can just click on continue. And here we will be having the list of compilers that we need to install. So just click it and select mark for installation. So by this way we are checking that. So just do the same for everything except Fortran. So just do the same for all. Once you are done checking the necessary stuff, to the leftmost top we will be having the installation. Select it and click on apply changes and just click on apply. So again this will download the necessary packages. Just be patient, and once everything is installed we will be getting this all changes were applied successfully. You may now close this dialog. So just click on close. And we can also close the MinGW installation manager. So now we need to add the MinGW installation location in our environment variable. So to quickly find that, just go to search and type MinGW and we'll be having this MinGW installation manager. We can just click on open file location and this will take us to this folder. Here also right click and select open file location again. So this will directly take us to the folder where MinGW has been installed. So it's in our local disk C MinGW folder. Go to that main folder of MinGW and click on bin. So we need to copy this particular path. Place your mouse on top and click on copy address. Now again go to search and type environment. We will be having the edit the system environment variables. Select that and go to environment variables, and here under system variables we need to select path. So scroll down, select path and edit. Here go to the top and click on new and just paste this path and click on OK. Click on OK everywhere. Now go to search and open command prompt and open it. So now here we will be running the command, which is g++ space hyphen hyphen version, and as you can see here I am getting the g++ MinGW version. If you get some error over here, we have made some mistake in the installation or we have added the wrong path. If you get the version, we have done everything perfectly. So now that we have set up the g++ path perfectly, next we need to download Visual Studio Code. So first thing, just Google Visual Studio Code and you'll be getting the first link from code.visualstudiocode.com. Just click that. And here you'll be having an option for download for Windows, and if you want to read it you can just scroll and read it. Just click it and the download will be getting started, and it is about 100 MB in size, the setup file. Just be patient till then. Once the download is complete, just double click and open it. You'll be getting the Visual Studio Code setup. Just click on I accept the agreement. If you want you can read it. Just click on next. This is going to be the location. I'll just leave it to default. Click on next. This is fine. Next. And make sure that you are checking everything over here like this. Yeah, this is good. And click on next and just click on install. So just be patient. Yeah, once the installation is complete, you will be having the launch Visual Studio Code. Just check that and click on finish. And you'll be getting the Visual Studio Code interface open like this. So after selecting our necessary theme over here, we need to open a folder to create our C++ project. So go to File and select Open Folder. And here just go to the folder location and create a new empty folder. And just name it whatever you want. I will just go with C++, okay? And we can just select it and click on Select Folder. So now this particular folder will be opened in our Visual Studio Code. You can just click Yes, I trust the authors. Now this folder is empty. We will be creating a C++ file inside it. So for that, click on this icon and just have a name for your file. Let me just go with new.cpp. We need to have the .cpp extension, which denotes that this is a C++ file. So once you create a .cpp file, you'll be getting a automatic notification from Visual Studio Code. As you can see, it asks us to install a C or C++ extension pack. So it says, do you want to install it? And here you need to just click on install. And the extension will be installed. So this just helps us with automatic code recommendations and IntelliSense. Let's just go and change the font size first because it looks so small initially. So for that, we need to go to settings, which is this icon. And here we need to click on again settings. And here we will be having the font size. Just place your cursor there and put a number. I would recommend you to go with 30. That's a good size. And you can just close the settings now. So now let's just go and code a basic C++ program. So it's going to be ash include. And as you can see, we are getting this recommendation automatically coming for us. This is because of the extensions that we have installed. So this makes coding much more simple. So now I am done writing a simple C++ program. And now let's see how we can run this. So first I'll be showing you how to run through terminal, and later I'll be showing you a shortcut extension which runs the program on a single click. Also make sure that you are saving the program. Control Yes. And to the top, we are having that three dot icon right near Go. Click on that. And we'll be having the terminal, new terminal, and we'll be getting the terminal opened here. And here we need to run the command G++ space your file name, which is new.cpp with extension. Hit enter. And this will compile the file first and will generate a.exe file. Now we need to view the output. So for that, run the command .a and hit enter. And as you can see, I'm getting the hello world in the output. So this is quite tiresome. We need to run two commands and open the terminal. So now I'll be showing you the shortcut way how to run the program. So for this, we need to install the code runner extensions. So to go to the extensions place, just click on this icon on the left pane. And here we can search any extension with the name. Just search for code runner. So this is that extension .run. We can just install it and trust publisher and install. It has so much of downloads. Once the extension has been installed, close and reopen Visual Studio Code. And after reopening Visual Studio Code, we are having that run with debug icon to the rightmost top. And near that, we are having the drop down. Click that and just click on run code. So this will automatically run our code. We don't need to like run any commands. So as you can see, I'm getting the hello world in the output. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.